Hare Krishna. Indulgence decreases our capacity to push against desire and increases desire's capacity to push us. Many times when we indulge in some pleasures, we often don't think what its consequences are. An alcoholic might drink once, just one drink, what difference does it make? But it's not just one drink. With every drink, the desire becomes stronger. See, for all of us, there are desires that pop up. They can pop up from within our minds, or they can pop up from the world outside. Either from internal recollection or from external perception. When they pop up, we have certain capacity to push them back. Now, if the desire is way too outrageous, then we will push it back very forcefully. Say, if we are honest and upright citizens and suddenly we get a desire pops up, let's steal something. Say, nothing doing. I just say that. But suppose the person has drunk alcohol regularly, then when the desire comes, let me drink. No, maybe yes, just one drink. What difference does it make? So what happens here? Inside us, the desire, when it pops up with certain force. It pushes us, do this, do this, do this. And we push it back. No, no, no. Now, in this situation, every time we indulge, when we indulge, our capacity to push against the desire weakens. On the other hand, the desire's capacity to push against us, to push us in towards the indulgence, increases. So, in that sense, whatever we do is not just one action. That one action is actually unintentional or unknowing commitment to similar future actions. So Krishna points to this dynamic that Asha Pashishatair Baddhaha Kama Krodha Parayanaha Ihante Kama Bhogartham Anyayenartha Sanchayan. So he says Asha Pashishatair Baddhaha. We can become bound by hundreds and thousands of desires. Kama Krodha Parayanaha. And we become sold out to Kama and Krodha. And when this happens, then Ihante Kama Bhogartham, in order to fulfill our selfish desires, Anyayenartha Sanchayan, we may even give up our ethics. We may act unrighteously to fulfill our desires. So thus, we get bound. So therefore, when we recognize that indulgence is not to be treated with nonchalance, it is a serious thing. And whatever pleasure we might get by indulgence, it will come at a heavy cost. Of course, we can't live without pleasure. When we start practicing bhakti yoga and connect with Krishna, that connection with Krishna, who is the supreme transcendence, gives us access to higher happiness. And the more we focus on seeking that higher happiness and savoring that happiness, then the urge to indulge will decrease, and the power of the desire to push us will decrease. And because we have a better option, our power to push against desire will also increase. Therefore, by resisting indulgence and persevering in transcendence, we can win our inner war. Thank you. Hare Krishna.